Now we're ready to get the neck of our vase started. So I've got the bowl, the other half of the bowl smoothed out and ready to go. First thing that we need to do is establish where the neck is gonna go and then cut out a hole, which will be the opening of our vase. So I can take, again, my fettling knife or a needle tool or whatever. I've got my bowl steadied in the middle, so it's spinning smoothly. And now I can just come down on top and determine where I want my opening to be and draw a little circle. So I can anchor my elbow and hold my needle tool really steady. While the banding wheel is spinning, I can draw circles. So wherever I think I want to cut my opening, that's for you to determine the width of your pot. And I can choose, I can draw little guidelines just to see what I like. If this is too wide, I can erase this, as long as I don't go too deep. So I think I like this circle right here, maybe a little wider. So this is going to be the opening to my vase. So I'm going to cut out all of this. Now that I have my opening determined, I can take a fettling knife, and I like to start from the middle and remove some of this clay first. I find that it takes the pressure off of my blade, and I can get a better cut as I get closer to the line that I chose. One of the reasons we want this centered here is because when we cut this, we want our opening centered too. If our bowl is off center, then that's gonna make, and it's wiggling around, that's gonna make our opening off center and difficult to work with. So it's important that this circle is parallel to this circle. There we go. So cutting this is really important also. So now that I've removed a bit of the clay, now I can go in, going really slowly following this line to make sure I cut a nice circle out of this. We want to make sure that the neck attaches really well. So I'm going to use my score tool to get this first coil on here really well. So I got that scored around the rim here. Now I can take some clay and rolling a nice coil. Score this. A little bit of water in here. I can begin to push this down. If this bowl was too soft, at this point the clay would start to flex down and smash on me, and I would want to stop and wait for this to firm up. It's really important to catch the clay at the right point. Good and leather hard. It's still soft enough to manipulate, firm enough to hold its shape. So the first thing I do is I get this coil attached really well. So I'm pushing it down on here really well, it's in place. The second thing I want to do is blend the seams. So I'm going around and I'm blending the seam on the outside, and then I'm blending on the inside. Make sure that's attached really well. Get it attached, blend the seams, and the third step for each coil is thinning it out. Now our steps are get it attached, blend it, and thin it out. I'm gonna, at this point, skip the third step. I'm gonna thin it all out at the end when I get all three coils attached. I'm just going to go right into the second coil here. Our end result is we want about
4 inches of height on our neck. So I would say 2 good-sized coils or 3 would be a good amount to put on here. I'm getting these attached. There we go. I'm blending the seams. So these joints as well. And I'm blending it. Can get our last coil on here. At this point, when we're attaching the coils, we want the neck to be 2 to 3 inches tall, so that's about 2 or 3 coils. We don't want it to be too much taller than that right now, because as we're smoothing it out, if it's really tall, we can't get our hands down inside it. Okay, so if you want a really tall neck, we have to build it up in stages. Okay, so now my neck is attached, the clay coils are attached, and I'm ready to begin smoothing this. Going through all the preliminary steps. Now we can start working with the water. So again, I'm just gonna get my fingers wet. And now we can start again from the bottom and work our way up to the top. And then we'll level this off. Just making sure everything is moist so my fingers can slide all over this. So the trick to this is keeping this spinning fast. As it gets taller, as you add more coils, it gets a little bit harder. So if the clay is soft and the speed is fast, you don't have to apply too much pressure. So most of your effort comes from rotating down here with this hand. Little bit of pressure really starts to smooth the soft clay out. So I'm just on the inside, just squeezing very lightly, and I'm thinning it out a little bit and smoothing it out. Now this neck is going to be significantly taller than the foot here, so I want to complete each level before I move up. So once the bottom is good, I can move up like a finger's distance to the next tier. And I can slowly progress up until this whole thing is smoothed out. So you're moving up one level at a time. So I'm keeping my fingers wet. I'm slowly moving up, smoothing the sides out, and thinning them out just a little bit. Again, we want this in the end to be about 1/4 inch thick, all the walls of this pot, so I don't want this to get too thin. And when I get all the way up, then I can start to level this out. To the top here, and then like we did with the foot, using the motion of this, and I got a fettling knife or a potter's knife, I can anchor my elbow so I'm stabilized, and slowly draw a line, and then I can either stop this. You just cut that line, or you can keep it spinning and remove the unevenness of the top. So you're forcing all the clay up to the top to level it off. All the walls are nice and even, and now the top is too. Now that it's level, I can do the same thing I did to the foot. So we can round out this top edge. Soften the sharpness from it. Use a sponge to help soften this. And now we can start to clean this up. So by general shaping, I can come in with my finger, and if I want to push this in, I can slowly start to push now that the walls are even. The clay will move a little bit easier. So again, most of the work is coming from keeping the pot spinning quickly. And then I'm using a little bit of pressure on this soft clay to push the neck in. And so we can shape this a little bit. Now I'm at the middle of the neck here. I can start kind of with my thumb on the inside. I'm pulling this out, flaring out the neck just a little bit. There's a nice shape to that. Lastly, before we connect these two, I can clean this up a little bit further by using some other tools that we have in our toolbox. This tool is called a rubber rib. It's flexible, and this is a wooden rib. There's lots of different rib tools, different shapes and materials, metal, rubber, wood. I'm gonna use this rubber rib right now, and again, keeping it spinning, I can scrape off some of the excess and weird bumps and help me shape this. The clay will conform to the shape of the rib tool, so how you hold this rib tool will determine different angles. So holding it straight, you'll get this angle. You can tighten the angle by holding your rib tool in a different way. We're just kind of cleaning this up and polishing it. And we can do a lot more decorating now or later when we attach these as well. We attach the two halves of this pot.